Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And the other day a lady had asked me a question that I always keep blaming God for the problems that I have in my life, and I never give him the credit for the good which is there. Neither am I grateful for the things which are there in my life which are adding value, nor am I taking responsibility for my own mistakes, my own failures, and I am simply putting the blame onto the Almighty. So what to do? How to reverse the scenario? Okay, so we will see how to do that today, hopefully. And this is a long process of inner engineering, which doesn't happen in day one itself, and it will not happen if you just see this video, but you will also have to follow the things which I will say in this video. Only then you will see some substantial change. Otherwise, even after 10 years, you will end up asking the same question to me or to some other spiritual guru. Okay, so if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation regarding your life or your marriage, your job, your health, or any other aspect of your life, then please go to my website. You will find the link of the website in the description of this video below, and you can book a reading with me. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So now, there is a saying in the scriptures that the biggest problem with the living entities, the biggest problem, what do you think, what that is? The biggest problem is we always take credit for things which we have not done. And we never take responsibility for the mistakes that we have done. Should I repeat? We always take credits for things which we have not done. And we never take responsibility for the faults which we have done. For the negative things which we have done. So whenever you will see in an organization also, especially in companies these days, and even in other places like schools, colleges, governments, anything good happens, everybody keeps saying, oh yeah, I was the one who suggested that idea. Oh yeah, you know, I was the one who told that you should not go this way, it's actually that way. So everybody wants to take credit. Even if they've done this much, they want to take this much credit. Now I'm not saying that you don't take credit, you take credit, but don't blow it out of proportion. Like, I know many people, especially some teachers I know. Suppose a person has done something very good in some field. Suppose he has become a big politician or a great astrologer or a great singer or a great anybody, sports person. Okay, very, very successful in some field. Then what happens is you will go to their teachers who used to teach them in their childhood. Even if they have taught them for one subject for 6 months, they will keep telling, oh yeah, you know, he's my student, she was my student. Now that's great, he or she was your student once upon a time, but to say that because you were his or her teacher, because of you that person is there, I think that's too much, to be very honest. Now if somebody tells me that, oh so I see your videos, Exotic Astrology videos, and then I have it in my chat, suppose, and then tomorrow that person becomes a big Bollywood star, so then I post it in my Facebook page, oh look, you know, that person was inspired by my videos. No, that it doesn't work like that. Now my videos might help her to be somewhere near that, or it might have contributed in that journey, but it doesn't mean that just by seeing my videos that person has reached that level. So that's the problem. You see, we always like to take credit for things which we have not done. And then let's go to the other side. When some mistake happens, we always try to hide it. We always try to prove to everybody that no, actually, you know, this is not a mistake. This is, but it is still not, you know, actually, if you see it that way, it is not a mistake. As in Hindi they say, na, dekhne wale ka nazariya hota hai. That's so rampant in the society these days. Nobody takes any responsibility for the faults which they have inside or whatever is going on in the society. Everybody will blame somebody else. The politicians are blaming the people. the people are blaming the politicians. The people are blaming the police. The police is blaming somebody else. The bureaucrats are blaming the politicians. The politicians are blaming the bureaucrats. This is going on, you see. And this will keep going on unless we learn to take responsibility for our own misdeeds which we have. As they say na in Sanskrit, nija dosha, our own faults. Those are not anybody else's faults. It is our own faults. And that is why we keep seeing faults in others. The moment we see some fault in somebody else, we have to understand, we are actually seeing a reflection of the fault which is inside us in somebody else. For example, if somebody is a thief, he or she keeps stealing things. Then if he sees a person, that a person is taking this mobile and going somewhere, what will he feel? He will think, oh, maybe he's also stealing. Now, maybe that mobile is that person's wife's mobile and he's just taking it with him. Or maybe that is his own mobile. But when the thief sees that that person is taking the mobile, he will think that, oh, look, he's trying to steal. As in scriptures, they say, na, Atmavan Manave Jagat. The world is a mirror of your own consciousness. So whenever you see faults in others, it is simply a reflection of the faults which we have inside ourselves. And we need to correct it. Otherwise, we will go on seeing faults. In Srimad Bhagavatam, there is the example of Prajapati Daksh, who was once upon a time the father-in-law of Lord Shiva. He was the father of the goddess Sati, who had given up her life once upon a time, who was the wife of Lord Shiva. And Daksh Prajapati was so vehemently afflicted by this disease of finding faults. It is said he used to find faults with the sun god. Can you imagine? Now, the moon has faults. Everybody knows the moon is dark. If you see, you will see dark spots. That is fine. Everybody knows. But what about the sun? Surya Narayan is very pure. There is no fault in sun god. But he used to see dark spots in the sun also. My god, see, so terrible. And then he started finding faults with Lord Shiva also. So what happens is, first we have a fault inside, then we see the fault in somebody else, then we find the fault in the entire society, and then we blame it to God. This is how it happens. First it starts with us, then our husband, our wife, then our mother, our father, then our best friend, then our friend, then our acquaintance, then the collector of the city, then the chief minister, then the president of the country, and then United Nations, and then God himself is cruel. Everything's terrible, right? This is how the cycle happens. Yes, that is what is happening. So when we have these tendencies, we have to see and read the scriptures, and we have to see the great divine examples which are there in the scriptures. So one of the favorite examples in this area can be of Hanumanji himself. If you read the Ramayana, you will see when Hanumanji had crossed the entire Lanka and he found Mother Sita and he came back, then all the other monkeys, his monkey friends, started asking him that, oh Hanumanji, please tell us, you have achieved such a great feat. You not only found Mother Sita, you also burned the entire Lanka. Wow, what an achievement that is. But Hanumanji didn't say, yeah, you know, it's me actually. Hum nahi hote to kya hota na? If I would not be there, what would happen? No, Hanumanji didn't say like that. Hanumanji always kept his profile low. Should I repeat? He always kept his profile low. Which means he could have started telling everybody, you know what I did, you know, actually Lord Ram told me to find Sita Devi, but I thought let's do something extra, you know, let's burn the Lanka and the entire city also. Imagine if somebody had done something like this today, how many updates he would post in Facebook. Imagine every 15 minutes he would keep posting an update, just found Sita Devi, just burnt Ravan's palace, just burnt Meghnad's palace, just burnt Lanka. Yes, and everybody would be liking there. 1 million likes in one day. That would happen because these days people are so much hungry for this fake attention that they will do anything to get it. So Hanumanji didn't do like that. Hanumanji, when he came back, he said, "Oh no, you know, actually I just jumped and I ate some fruits in this Ashok Vatika, and then they started fighting with me. I started fighting, and then I thought it's a good idea to burn the Lanka also." That's it. He said as if he had not done anything. I mean, he did not downgrade himself. He said what he did, but he did not show that he was like, he did not show like that. He always kept his profile low. We should also tell what we have done, but at the same time, our profile should be low. Then there is humility. Otherwise, if that is not there, then my God, tomorrow something bad happens to us. We will not be able to take it. That is why when somebody is insulted sometimes very badly, that person goes and commits suicide. Why? Because that person has now understood that he cannot maintain his image in front of others. That image is finished. So the person cannot live in this world, you see. It's so terrible for him. So when we read the scriptures, we see great examples like this. Another befitting example in this category is Yudhishthir Maharaj. Once the Kauravas had gone to Dronacharya when the Kurus and Pandavas, they were small in the ashram of Dronacharya. They were learning martial arts and teaching archery and all these things. And then one day the Kauravas, means the party of Duryodhan and the 99 brothers, all of them, they went to Dronacharya and said, "Oh, we think actually you are more partial to the Pandavas than us. You like them more than us." Yes. So it is not good, you know. A guru should like everybody equally. A guru should not be partial. What is that which is there in them which is not there in us? Why do you like Yudhishthir more than our brother Duryodhan? What's so bad in Duryodhan? And what is so great in Yudhishthir? I don't find anything great in Yudhishthir. Now the Kauravas were saying like this. So please tell us why you like them more than us. Of course, not only Dronacharya would like them more, everybody would like them more, except the Kurus, of course. So then Dronacharya thought, okay, let's teach them a very good lesson. So then what Dronacharya did, he said, "My dear Duryodhan, please come here. My dear Yudhishthir, please come here." And then he said, "Take a pot," and he gave some rice or grains or something in those pots to both of them. Yes. And then he said to Yudhishthir Maharaj, "My dear Yudhishthir, please go around the ashram, wherever you want to go, please go. And whenever you find somebody who is more degraded than you, please go and give this pot to that person." And then he said to Duryodhan, "Duryodhan, take this pot, go and give this pot to somebody who is elevated than you, who is superior to you." If you know what's the outcome, then write it in the comments. Pause this video and write it in the comments. So then what happened? Yudhishthir Maharaj went across the ashram. He saw everywhere. He roamed all the places. But he could not find anybody who is inferior to him. Because he used to feel that I am the most inferior person. And this is not inferiority complex. This is humility. Humility and inferiority complex, they look alike. But they are actually totally opposite. Inferiority complex is another product of self-absorption, and humility is the product of faith and belief in God, that God is great, I am nobody in front of him. That is actually humility. So Yudhishthir Maharaj could not find anybody who is more inferior than him. He was thinking, whenever he used to see somebody, because he had so many good qualities, the moment he will see somebody, he will see something good in them. And then he will think, "Oh, this person has this good quality, but I don't have that. So this person is better than me." And with Duryodhana, it was the opposite. Duryodhana, he had so much superiority complex that he used to think that he is the best. And then what happened is, whenever he used to see somebody, he used to see faults. he will see, oh, this person doesn't look good, this person is not intelligent, because you know I am the most handsome, I am the most intelligent, this person has this problem, this person has that problem, that person has this problem, so you know I am the best, actually I am the most superior, so nobody is superior to me. So at the end of the day, both of them came back to Dronacharya and said, Dronacharya started laughing. Then Dronacharya asked Yudhishthir Maharaj, he said, oh Dharmaraj Yudhishthir, what happened? Why are you coming with the pot back? I thought you will come empty-handed. And then Yudhishthir Maharaj said, I am sorry my dear Guru Maharaj, I am the most degraded and inferior person who is there in this entire place. Because anywhere I see, I am seeing they have some good quality which I don't have. And then he asked, my dear Duryodhana, how about you? So, oh my dear Guru Maharaj, actually you know the problem is everybody is inferior to me actually. I am the most superior. So, because wherever I see they have some faults, you know. So, there is nobody who is superior to me. So, I am the most superior. So, I could not give this to anybody. And then everybody had a good laugh and the Kauravas were thinking, my God, what a leader we have. Yes, these examples are there in the scriptures. So when we read these scriptures and we understand the lives of these great personalities, only then we will get the inspiration to remain humble and to not blame others. And regarding blaming God or blaming others or blaming society, see, we take all the decisions. We will not read scriptures. We will not consult our gurus. We will do whatever we want. And then when things don't go our way, then we will blame God, right? Many people tell me that, oh, you know, this relationship did not work. It ended in a divorce. It ended in a, breakup. Yes, many relationships these days. Well, who told you to get into a relationship with that person? It was your decision. It is your problem of discrimination. I don't care you are a boy or you are a girl. You can keep writing things anywhere in Facebook or wherever that, oh, this person cheated me, that person cheated me. You do not have the power of discrimination. You do not know who to accept as your life partner. That is your problem. That is not God's problem. Don't blame God for your failed relationships. Now somebody will write in the comments that, oh, you are wrong. I did everything. That person did not reciprocate. Well, even then, it was you who decided to go into the relationship. It was all your decision. Nobody came and told you that do like this. It was all your decision to do. So, people, they will drink, they will smoke, they will not study for exams. And then when they get less marks, they will curse God. Yes. People, they will eat meat, they will do all sorts of nefarious activities, and then when they will have some health problem, then they will go and blame God. Then you will see all these things, you know. Oh, every day in Ganeshji's temple I used to put 1 rupee. Why did I get this disease? Lord Ganesh doesn't exist, you know. Especially in Mumbai, Maharashtra, you go, you will find people talking like this. Any problem they have, they will blame it on either Ganesh or Lakshmi, either of the two. And in South India, any problem you have, they will blame it either on Shiva or Balaji, either of the two. And in East India, God knows. So, this is what is going on. We do all the nonsense and then we put the blame on God, you see. We will not follow proper schedule, which is there in the scriptures, that you should get up early in the morning, you should chant mantras, you should read the scriptures. By that, your intelligence is cleared. You know what to choose in life, that you will not do. And then when you don't do that, and then you see terrible results, instead of being humble and telling to yourself that, yes, I did a mistake, you will go on blaming God. And then you go and say, oh, actually, you know, God doesn't answer to my prayers. No, he will never answer. If you do not read the scriptures and understand what God wants you to do. Many times people ask that, how do we know what God wants us to do? It's very simple. Read the scriptures. He has given us the scriptures. we have to associate with those people who have the knowledge of the scriptures. They will tell us what is right, what is wrong, when to do what and when not to do what. Now, when we don't do that, we go on with our own whimsical mind, as the Bhagavatam says, na manorathe na sati dhavato bahi. Manoratha, the chariot of the mind is going today from this girl to that girl, tomorrow from this boy to that boy, from this movie star to that movie star. It's going like this, you know. And then what happens? You are like, oh, see, it didn't work. It collapsed. You got fired from your job, yes. Because why? You are doing something which you absolutely hate. So many people these days, they are doing things which they absolutely hate for 8 hours. Can you imagine? And then their performance is low. And then they say, oh, my boss fired me. Why will he not fire you? Even if maybe you were your own boss, you would have fired yourself. So don't blame your boss or anybody. Of course, at an ultimate level, you can say that is your own karma, what is happening. You don't have the right to blame anybody. But even on a gross sense, before you blame somebody, always look within. Read the scriptures, understand these great personalities. In Srimad Bhagavatam, there is the example of Mahajans, all the 12 Mahajans. Swayambhu Narada Shambhu Kumaro Kapilo Manu Prahlado Janako Bhishmo Balirvaya Sakhi Vayam. These 12 personalities, I have a video on 12 Mahajans. If you have not watched it, go to my channel and type MAHAJANS, Mahajans. You will see it. So, you have to learn from the exemplary personalities how they behaved in times of calamity. Okay? And then we will learn to accept our own faults and not blame God for everything which happens. Okay? Because He didn't tell you to choose that boy or that girl. It was you who decided. Okay. So after deciding, after having all the enjoyment, now do not blame God. Okay. He didn't tell you that do this. It was you who decided, yes, let's have fun. So now you pay the price, you see. All right. There you go. If you are new to the channel, that's been quite a heavy video, I would say. Heavy dose for Monday morning. If you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it, hopefully. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who always keeps blaming others for your problem, for their own problems. And if you want a consultation regarding your life or your marriage or your career or health or any other aspect, then you can book a reading with me personally, one-to-one. You can go to my website. You will find the link of the website in the description of this video below. Okay? Until next time, wish you good luck and hope that you don't blame anybody else for your own problems. Okay? Bye-bye. See you.